Hello, there is Christian, and welcome back to my computer in Fusion 360. Today I'm playing around with the pyramids, a straight normal pyramid and a twister one. This is from a Facebook questions, and there are some other ways to do this. This is just a very fast way to do it, and you do not have very much control more than the twist angle. Everything fixes itself. If you want to do some strange twisting, you need to do some other workflow. Let's talk about the straight pyramid first. A pyramid is a square face and four equilateral triangular faces. It's basically a half octahedron. If we would mirror this one, we'd have an octahedron. So the workflow is slightly the same as an octahedron. I try to do things slightly different when I do them every time. Keeps my brain fresh. So let's start a new design. We're going to start with a new sketch on our bottom plane. Create. Polygons, circumscribe or any one you want. We just need four sides as we are doing a square. We're going to tell Fusion this line here is going to be horizontal. The thing now I need to project to another plane is the hive. The hive is going to be the side length here, but from the corner and then lift it up so we meet the center point. Going to be clear in a while. Talking about it sounds really stupid. The thing is, I want to avoid create a new plane diagonally or stuff like that. I want to use the built-in planes, specifically this one up here. So what I do, we're going to do a circle, construction circle, from here to here. What I normally do, I do a line from the corner through the center point and make it the same length as the side. But doing a circle of this like this, I can now do a line out here, make it something like this. We can constrain it in every direction. We make it horizontal. We make it a coincident, the line with the center point, and we make it equal to one of the sides, like that. So now we're done. It starts to get black lines here. It says it's fully defined of him, but we are missing the dimension. And the dimension I'm going to use is from the center point to one corner, and then diagonally out or aligned out. This is going to be the height of a pyramid. So let's do it 50 millimeters to start off like that. Let's pull it out a bit, out of the way. So by doing that, we're done all the sketching we need on the base plane. So we're going to finish. Going to turn around a bit. We're going to create a new sketch. And now I'm going to choose the plane that is aligned with the line I did earlier. We're going to project. So let's do this one. We're going to do it P on the keyboard for project. And we'll project in the line we did. And I'm going to project in this edge here. And I hit OK. And I turn off my first sketch. I want to see this. To not get confused, I like to turn this one into construction geometry. We're going to make a circle. Construction circle from out here to into here. Like that. Now we're going to find the height of our little pyramid. The height is going to be from the midpoint. This is the center point. Turn off on the sketch. This is the center of a square. We're going to do it up to the circle. Hit it with a vertical constraint. And I'm going to do one more line, which I'm going to use later for our twisted pyramid. If it's not necessary for the normal pyramid, from the edge here up to the top here. And by doing that, I'm going to hit finish. So, doing the normal pyramid, S key to search for command. We're doing the loft, and we're doing the blue one, which is the solid one, from this profile up to the top up here. Okay, we turn off the sketches for a while. Now we have a pyramid. We can shake it. Vertex of the top to the flat plane, 50 millimeters. Any two edges we choose, 70.711, 70.71. Yeah, they're all equal. So that's a nice pyramid. That's the easy one. That was a bit much harder. We need to turn on our sketches. I'm going to delete this loft command, and we're going to do the twister one. And to do that, we're going to use the sweep command. Once again, S and type in to get the sweep. The blue one is all ourselves. I'll probably create. You want to find it there. The profile is once again this one. The path. That's where I made a solid line up here. I'm going to use this as a path. And now we get a square cubey thing. The thing is, what's good with sweep command, we have both taper angle and twist angle. So we're going to start with the taper angle. And we're going to tell Fusion, as I like math, but I hate doing it. So we're going to use measure. click somewhere out in the open so nothing is selected, and then I'm gonna click on this line. This is why I made this little construction line here. This is the angle up to the top. So if I click this one, it goes the wrong way. No problem. Taper angle, back up, and hit the minus sign before. And by that, we have made our own, basically the same thing as we lofted. I'm going to open the command again because I didn't mean to stop it. Now we had a twist angle. Let's make it like 70 degrees. And by doing that, we can twist it basically as much as we want. We can do one full revolution, 360 degrees. And it looks like that. And you play around as much as you will. It gives you not very much control. You can basically just twist it. It's going to be an even twist all the way. You can see the pitch is constant up to the top, basically. But this is a very easy way to, like 45 degrees, something like that. You can make a nice geometric shape of a twisted pyramid, which are very stable. So we can now show our sketches. Click on the first sketch, right click, and choose show dimensions. This is parametric driven. We can now change this to 361 millimeters. Chickling. And it updates everything. So it's parametric driven. So this is just a short thing. I hope it's helpful for you. So remember, the sweep command has both taper angle and twist angle. It's the only command right now. It might be others in the future. So with that, take care, see you around, and bye.